Hey everyone, April here. I'm back at you with some more Power Platform and M365 videos. So ever since I did that video a while back now on how you can recreate the SharePoint approval out-of-the-box workflow in Power Automate, I've had a lot of you requesting how I can do the same thing with the Collect Feedback workflow in SharePoint and recreate that in Power Automate. So that's exactly what I'm going to show you how to do today. The Collect Feedback workflow is honestly pretty similar to the out-of-the-box approval workflow. Rather than asking for an approve or reject though, we're just gonna give an open text box where a user can put in comments and reply with some feedback. So I'll walk you through how we set this up in Power Automate, how we set up the underlying SharePoint list to handle it, and all the steps involved right after this. Let's start off by taking a look at the Collect Feedback workflow that I've created in Power Automate in action, and then we'll decouple it and show how I built it. Now, the workflow I'm going to be showing is all based around a SharePoint document library, but this same method that I'm showing could be applied for a SharePoint list as well. So what I want to have happen is I have a document library here with some training assets or PowerPoints, and I want to be able to select a particular item in here, like maybe this building your first Power App presentation that I have, and send this to a few of my colleagues to review and give me some feedback. Now to do this, we'll use one of the built-in triggers in Power Automate that lets us execute a flow for a selected item or file in SharePoint. So how this will look is we'll click on an item, we can click on the three dots, and we see this automate option, which you'll also see here in the ribbon as well. So there's two ways to get to this. And when we do that, we'll see all of the flows that we have associated with this particular SharePoint list to trigger manually like this. Request sign-off is a built-in workflow that's there automatically. Collect Feedback is the one that I've created. So to see this in action, we'll click on that. This will open up a panel on the right-hand side where we can fill out some additional information about what we want to have happen here. So similar to some of the out-of-the-box workflows that we had in old-school SharePoint, where we could fill in who we want to send this to and some comments. So that's exactly what I have here. In this Assign To field here, I can type one or many people that I want to send this feedback to. So I'm just going to select David for this example. And then I can specify a message. So what exactly am I wanting feedback on from him? So maybe I want to say, please review and see if I missed anything. Now when I click Run Flow, this is going to execute the workflow. And what's going to happen behind the scenes is David is going to get an email letting him know that I've requested feedback. So if we switch over to his profile and go into his email, we see there is that automated email from Power Automate. We see the subject is feedback requested for, and it's taking in the name of that document. We see who it was requested by, myself, the date it was created, and a link to open up and see the PowerPoint. So if I click on that, it's going to pull that up and I can review it. And then right here in line in that email, David can provide his comments. So maybe I'll just say, looks great, click submit, and this will finish out the process. And if you'll notice, I kind of did one extra little thing that I'll show you how to do here in a little bit at the end, where we have a field called comments. And it's just a hyperlink. So if I click on this little folder icon, it's gonna take me over to where those underlying feedback comments are stored. And how I have this working right now is I have another list just called feedback, and I'm storing that data here. Now, there are a few different ways that we could tackle this. We could have just appended all of this feedback into, say, a multi-line of text column in that document library itself. But I felt this way was a little bit cleaner. So what I'm doing is we have the list. In the title field, I'm storing the person's name that gave the feedback. The comments are going to be stored here in the comments field. And then I have a lookup column with item ID that's going to look up to the associated item that they're giving feedback for. And that's how that's associated. So that enables me to be able to click on that link and see a filtered view of the comments just for that item. All right, now let's jump over to Power Automate and we'll see how we build this. To start, you want to go to the My Flows tab, and here under the New Flow menu, the type of flow we want for this is an instant cloud flow. These are flows that we can manually trigger. And if we scroll down through this list here, one of the options that you'll see is for selected file. Now the key distinction here is you have to decide, are you wanting to run this for a SharePoint list or a SharePoint library? If you're wanting to run it from a SharePoint library, like the demo I just showed, you're going to do the for selected file. If it's a SharePoint list, on the other hand, you'll do the for selected item. So there are two different triggers for this, whether you're using a list or a library. So I'm going to select the for selected file trigger, and I'm going to give my workflow a name, and we'll call this Collect Feedback V2 because I already have a working version of this. Now for the trigger, you're going to point it to the SharePoint site that has the SharePoint library that you want to trigger these feedback requests from, which in my case is this training site. And then you'll select the library name, which is the training assets in my case. First thing we have to do within this trigger is you notice we have the option here to add an input. And when I click that, it gives me a few different options where we can add text, yes, no, file, email, number, and date. That right there, these settings, are what enable us to, back in this workflow here, when we trigger it, if we open up that panel where we had the option there to be able to put in the assigned to and the message to the person, these are those trigger inputs. So the first thing I want to do is we'll define a trigger input of an email type. And I just renamed this, so the default's going to say email to assigned to. And then I added one more input, which is just a text input type. And rather than saying input, I called this one message. So I'm giving those two inputs when the user triggers this workflow to enter in that information. A thing to note about these trigger inputs, if you've never used them, is when you add them, they're automatically required. So if for some reason, maybe you didn't want the message to be required, you can click on those three dots next to that input, and you can select the option to make this field optional. Next thing we want to do is we want to look up the information about this particular item so that we can pass it in to our request for feedback. And the reason this is necessary to do is because this for selected file trigger doesn't actually give us any data about the item itself. So to show you what I mean, if I were to add in a new step and do, say, just a compose so that you can see what's available. And in our input here, if we look at the dynamic content, you'll see this is all the data that we have based off of the trigger. So this is different if we're using an automated trigger for, say, when a new file is added or when an item is edited in a SharePoint list, where you have all of that metadata stored in the list. For this one, all it's giving us is the unique identifier, the ID of the item, and then some information such as who is actually executing this workflow or triggering it, which is stored in the username and email fields, and the timestamp at which it was executed, and then any custom input properties that you defined, like we did with the assigned to and the message. But if we look at my list, you see I had several more points of data, like the status and a title and training ID and all of that. That data isn't showing here. That's why we need to do an additional step to retrieve that. So let's delete this compose and we'll add a new step. And the one we want is get file properties. And we'll do this one here. You notice there's two, there's get files, plural, and get file property. We want the singular because we're just going to return the selected file that we have here. And we have to do the same thing, pointing it to the site address and the list. And then for the ID, we'll use our dynamic content and we'll associate it of the ID of our trigger in the for selected file. And now that we'll get all of the data that we need to be able to pass into our request for feedback. So now's the bulk of this workflow. How do we actually go and request that feedback? Well, what I'm going to do is reuse the out-of-the-box approval mechanism that Power Automate offers. Now, I know this isn't an approval, but we can customize it to make it a mechanism to request feedback instead. So let's add a new step and do a search for approval. And we'll do the start and wait for an approval. Here in the approval type, you know we have the approve reject, everyone must approve, and the approve reject first respond. We looked at those when we recreated the approval workflow in here. But you'll notice below, we have custom responses as well. So if we want to do something like collecting feedback, we can utilize the custom responses instead. When you set up the custom responses, you do have to decide if you want to wait for all responses or if you want to wait for one response, similar to if you're doing the approve reject. Typically in a collect feedback, you would want feedback from everyone that you're assigning it to in most cases. So you would probably choose this custom responses, wait for all responses. And you see when we do that, we have the option to have a response option item that we can fill in and customize. So for that, I'm just going to put in an option called feedback. I'm just going to leave it at that as one single option. So you're not going to have two buttons where you click approve or reject. It's just one type of response that we're allowing. And this will automatically give that text input box in the email that we saw when I did the demo. All I have to do at this point is fill in the title, which will be the subject of the email that they get in the approval. So in my case, I just typed in the words feedback requested for, and then I'm going to use my dynamic content. And this is where the get files property action is going to become helpful. So I want to pull in the title of that file that we want them to provide feedback for. So we're going to click that title field, and that will pull that in there into the title. And then for the assign to, this is where we're going to use those input properties that we defined up here in our trigger. So if you look at the dynamic content and scroll down under the for selected file header, we'll choose that assign to input. And the same thing for details, we want to pull in that input property we added for message. And the last two are item link and description. That's that hyperlink that I provided in the demo there to open up the actual PDF that I'm requesting feedback for. To get that item link, we'll use the dynamic content again and do a search for link is the easiest way to find it. And there's a built-in dynamic property here for link to item that we can use. And for the description, it can be whatever you want for the item link. So I'm just going to have that be the title. Now, if we were using the approval mechanism to have this be an approve or reject scenario, typically we would have a condition below this where we would check to see, was this approved or was it rejected? And then do different things based off of that. Because we're only allowing one type of response, which is a input of a feedback, we don't need all of that in here. So we can go straight to whatever the next action is. In this case, this is where I want to leverage that feedback list. So remember where we clicked on one of these comments here and that filtered this feedback list? That's how I've chosen to set this up. So you can create another SharePoint list, just a blank list like I did, reuse this title field, and we just need to add two more columns. So you go to add column, you'll add a multi-line of text column and name that comments as I did here. And then you'll add a lookup column, which you can get to by clicking the more option, choosing this lookup option, and then below you can point it to whatever SharePoint library you're wanting to kick off this feedback from, which for me is this training assets library. And then the other thing that you'll want to do is once you choose the list for the lookup, you want to choose the column that you're looking up for. And I chose the ID column to match it on that. So with the workflow, we want to create a new item here in this feedback list with the feedback that was provided. So to do that, back in our workflow here in Power Automate, we're going to add a new step and we'll do the create item step for SharePoint. For the site address, we'll point it back to that training site. And for the list name this time, we're going to choose our feedback list that we just created. I'm reusing the title field for the person's name that submitted the feedback. So to get that, we're going to use our dynamic content in this start and wait for approval action section. And the property we want is the responses approver name. And you'll notice as soon as I do that, it's wrapped my create item action inside and apply to each. The reason for that being, we could technically assign this feedback request to multiple people. So it's actually going to put those outcomes of who responded and what their comments were in an array or a group or table of items. So we have to loop through that, which is why that put that here into the apply to each. So I'll just finish filling out this property here for the comments. We want to map that under our start and wait for approval section to this responses comments property. And finally, for the item ID lookup, we'll click the dropdown. We'll go to enter custom value and we'll choose the ID from get file properties. So we could stop here or we could do one extra step of having it send an email or even a Teams chat notification to the user that requested this, letting them know what the feedback was and that it was provided. So to do that, all we need to do is after this create item action, we can add a new action. And let's just do the send email one, I guess. So we'll do a send email. We'll choose this Outlook send email V2. And for the two, to get the person that requested this, we'll choose the add dynamic content option. And we'll scroll down in the for selected file. And the one we want is this user email. That's the person that kicked off this workflow. And then we can just fill out our subject and body. So I'll do feedback provided for, and I'll pull in the title, and I'll pull in the person who approved it. So I'll say they have provided feedback. Here it is. And then we'll pull in the response comment to get the feedback there. All right, so let's give this a save. And the beauty of this is it's really customizable. Like I said, instead of doing an email, you could add an action, click on the Teams connector, and we can use the post a message as the flow bot to a user action, and we can send them this same notification here inside of Teams instead if you didn't want to spam their inbox. So this is all saved. We'll do one more quick test. So we're going to go back here to our document library. I'll click on one of these items, go to my Automate dropdown. When you first start one of these workflows off, it will have you connect to the different connectors that it uses, which in this case is SharePoint, the Approvals, and Outlook connectors. So we'll just continue. You only have to go through that one time when you initially kick it off. And we'll put in the assigned to. So I'll send that to David again, and I'll put in a message. And click Run. If we go back to Power Automate and look at the workflow run history, we can see that it is running. And if I switch over to David's profile, I see that he just got an email requesting feedback. So here's that item. I can click on that, see the document, of course, and I'll put my feedback in. Then we'll switch back over to my profile. And in my feedback list, I'll see the comments there. All right, so last thing I want to show you, if you did want to do it the way that I have it listed here with the separate list, and you want to be able to click on this icon and have that take you right there to the feedback for that particular item, this is all done using SharePoint column formatting. So first thing I did is I created a new column that's a single line of text column, and I didn't put any data in that field because I want that just to be this hyperlink to take me to the comments. Next, I clicked on the dropdown on that column. I went to column settings and then format this column. Then from here, I did the advanced mode option at the bottom left. And you'll see that gives us a blank text box. And if you've watched any of my other videos on some SharePoint list formatting examples, this should look pretty familiar, where we can paste in a block of JSON. So I'll provide a link to a file that has this JSON that you need in it, but it's pretty simple. So I'm gonna just paste that in here right now. And really all we're doing is we're getting an icon from the Office UI Fabric icons for the folder. And I'm wrapping that in an A tag so we can have a hyperlink. And the main thing to note here is how I formatted the hyperlink. So all I did is I went to my feedback list and I clicked on the item ID, which is that lookup field for the different items that we kicked it off for. And I applied a filter, just any filter you want. So maybe I want to filter by items with ID 3. And that gives us this URL with a couple query string parameters in it. So we can see we have the name of our list, feedback, all items, and then we have filter field 1 equals item ID, which is this column, and we have and filter value 1 equals 3. So that's our filter there. We can just copy that exact URL, and here in our list formatting URL, we can paste that and replace the filter value 1 equals after the equal sign. Instead of hard coding that ID, we can dynamically pull in the ID of this item that you have selected, or the item of the row there, using the dollar sign ID in brackets. So that's really all I did. I'm just leveraging the built-in query string parameters that filtering gives us for a list. So I'm saying, hey, take me to this list that has this pre-filtered. So pretty simple and cool use case for some column formatting. So that's really all there is to it for recreating the collect feedback workflow for SharePoint with inside of Power Automate. I will make this workflow available as an exported zip file that you can just import into your environment here on the Power Platform Samples repo that you can get to at aka.ms/powerplatform-samples. So that'll be available here, and you can just filter by the Power Automate tab, and I will make that available so that you can get to that with some detailed instructions about how to install it and all of that. And I'll include a link as well for that column formatting if you're interested in that. You know, and one of the other reasons I decided to make this video, besides a lot of you requesting it since my approval video there, is I noticed a lot of people recently have been taking my LinkedIn learning course that I did a year or so back on how to migrate from SharePoint Designer to Power Automate. And that's pretty exciting because the time is ticking on when SharePoint Designer workflows are reaching end of life. So 2026, which is really not that far away, SharePoint Designer workflows will no longer be supported. So you'll need to migrate those off to Power Automate. That's why it's so important that we understand how we can recreate things like some of the approval workflows and collect feedback and all of that. So hopefully this video was helpful in figuring out how to do the collect feedback and to recreate that so that you can start getting those SharePoint Designer workflows, if you have them, moved over to Power Automate. Thank you so much for watching, and if you found this helpful, please do me a favor, share it with your friends, give it a thumbs up, and hit that subscribe button. I'll catch you in the next video.